We did an analysis looking at this because I wanted to look under the hood. I wanted to figure out more about this because A, it was so pertinent to what we do always as healthcare providers in the space. We are social animals. But this was in fact so amplified during COVID because remember, social isolation is not loneliness. So the quarantine led to social isolation, which is geographical distance. But social isolation can increase the risk for loneliness. They're very different phenomena. So social isolation is objective. Loneliness is subjective. Many of us like to spend an afternoon by ourselves. You're socially distanced, but you're not lonely. And there's many people who go to the cocktail party with 300 people in the room who feel very lonely. They're very different phenomena. And loneliness, not social isolation, is associated with an activated immune system. The body reacts to loneliness as a stressor. So along with the long list of stressors that people were facing this last 2 years, there's one that we, in fact, rely on for resiliency that now flipped and became a stressor. That was loneliness. And when human beings report loneliness, and we've looked at this now in my lab, is that they're more likely to exhibit increase in CRP, inflammation, increase in interleukin-6, interleukin-1, and so on and so on and so on. But the message is, we think this is in part why you're seeing a rise, not just in mental illness in people who are lonely, but also some of these, in quotes, inflammatory medical problems like heart disease and diabetes and obesity. Something I thought was very interesting. So what can we do about it? Well, do you rent a friend? I mean, what do you do? What do you do? Is there an anti-loneliness pill? What's there? Well, this was a really interesting study right here from the great state of Texas. This is a very scalable, cost-effective study where they took some college students, trained them on just some empathic listening skills, and they went out to a Meals on Wheels, kind of an indigent but older population, asked them to complete a loneliness scale. And this was right during the height of COVID. And the loneliness ratings were very high. There's a couple of scales called the Dijon and the UCLA loneliness scales. And then they randomly assigned them. They randomly assigned them just to, we'll get back to you later, while the other group just got empathy calls, just a quick call, 10 minutes over a period of several weeks. And in that very brief intervention, their depression scores came down, their anxiety scores came down, loneliness came down, overall well-being increased. And this really caught my attention because we don't have enough healthcare providers in mental health. And the technology might provide scalable solutions. And this doesn't always have to be done by a person, that is a live, breathing person. And I could envisage a comprehensive, coherent, evidence-based care plan for patients in the future that will actually provide specific attention to this issue, because this loneliness pandemic ain't going away.